I suggest.
Hello, everyone. Surprise! So, I am actually officiating the wedding. So, thank you all for coming, everyone. We appreciate it and we love you all. Okay. Friends, Matt and Laura have invited us here today in the presence of God to share in the celebration of their marriage. We who gather here today are separated by the many different experiences that we have had. Despite these differences, we gather here today in this place because we share something in common. We share a desire to affirm and support the relationship of Matt and Laura. Marriage is an act of will. It requires a commitment to care for another person. By caring, we show concern for the life and growth for those whom we love. By responding, we experience the needs of that other person and try to help meet those needs. Today, guided by God's love and wisdom, we affirm and celebrate Matt and Laura's wedding day. Okay. Before God, your friends, and your families, I ask you to affirm your willingness to enter the covenant of marriage and to share all the joys and sorrows of your lives and your relationship, whatever the future may hold. Matt, do you take this woman to be your wife? Do you promise to love her, comfort her, honor and keep her in sickness and in health as long as you both shall live?
I do.
Got one. Laura, do you take this man to be your husband? Do you promise to love him, comfort him, honor and keep him in sickness and in health as long as you both shall live? Repeat after me. I take you, Laura, this day as my wife.
I take you, Laura, this day as my wife.
I promise to walk by your side forever as your best friend and your soulmate.
I promise to walk by your side forever as your best friend and soulmate.
You are my beloved one, and I am proud to marry you.
You are my beloved one, and I am proud to marry you.
I promise to support your dreams and to be there for you all our lives.
I promise to support your dreams and to be there for all our lives.
Repeat after me. I take you, Matt, this day as my husband.
I take you, Matt, this day as my husband.
I promise to walk by your side forever.
To walk by your side forever.
As your best friend and your soulmate.
As your best friend and your soulmate.
You are my beloved one, and I am proud to marry you.
You are my beloved one, and I am proud to marry you.
I promise to support your dreams and to be there for you all our lives.
I promise to support your dreams and be there for all our lives.
From the earliest times, the circle has been a symbol of completeness, a symbol of committed love. An unbroken and never-ending circle symbolizes a commitment of love that is also never-ending. This ring should be a reminder of the commitment to love each other that you have made today. Now we have to get our rings out. Repeat after me. I, Matt, give you, Laura, this ring as a symbol of my commitment.
This ring as a symbol of my commitment.
To love, honor, and respect you.
To love, honor, and respect you.
Repeat after me. I, Laura.
I, Laura.
Give you, Matt.
Give you, Matt.
This ring as a symbol of my commitment.
This ring as a symbol of my commitment.
To love, honor, and respect you.
To love, honor, and respect you.
Okay. Now you can put your rings on. Matt and Laura, You have now affirmed your love for each other before your family and friends. You have come from different backgrounds, have walked different paths. You are different individuals. Your love has transcended these differences. In the years before you, may the richness of traditions that have nurtured you enhance and brighten your lives as you help to create and shape the future. May God bless you and keep you. Matt and Laura, by the power vested in me, I now pronounce you husband and wife. Groom, you may now kiss the bride! Yay! It is my pleasure to present to you Mr. and Mrs. Silva.
So we've got to kind of watch Laura and Matt's response to these questions. This is called the wedding shoe game. Number one, who has the better shower singing voice? That's one for Laura. Yeah, okay. Who is the pickier eater? Who's the pickier eater? Matt wins that one. Let's see. Who controls the credit cards?
Ah! Hi, Matty. You know that answer.
That just changed.
We're doing all right. Who is more likely to burn the house down when they're cooking dinner? Oh! Discrepancy. Who spends the longer amount of time getting ready for a night out?
Matt.
Which one of you is more stubborn? Matt's afraid to answer this one.
How about that? That's a...
That was a time. Who takes up more than their half of the bed? That's a time. That's good. Who is better at keeping secrets?
Oh, yes. Yeah.
Matt says he is. Ty, you guys are tying up pretty good here. Who is more likely to be running late And I think I know the answer to that. Yeah, Laura. They call you last minute Laura, from what I understand. One of your daughters, I think it was Kelly, that told me that. All right, who spends more money? Well, okay, you each do. That's good. You'll be married happily for a long, long time. Which one of you is the better dancer? Ah, Laura. That's awesome. Who is more organized? Who's the most organized? Matt. Who is more likely to get a traffic ticket? Laura. Which one of you is the loudest? Who's the loudest? Laura? Laura's inching in the lead now.
Is in the lead.
Is in the lead, yes. Uh-oh, now this is significant here. Who is the better kisser? Ooh, Laura wins that one hands down. Good one, Matt. That's a good one. Yes. Who loses things the most? Who's always looking for something? Who loses something? Laura does that. Okay. We're going to find out as we go on through the night, which one of you can hold their liquor better?
Matt.
That's a boy, Matt. This kind of goes in along with the ticket question. Which one of you is the safer driver? Matt. So Laura's liable to get a ticket, but Matt's a better... Yeah, that makes sense. Who said, "I love you" first? Matt, way to go, bro. Last question. Who has the better taste in music? Laura.
So who got it here?
I'll tally these up and let you know how you did here. Here we go. Kelly to the rescue, ladies and gentlemen.
Hello, Matthew and Laura. It's Paul, the best man. Just want to say congratulations, first and foremost. And secondly, that, you know, I'm very sorry I couldn't be there. A little laid up in the hospital here. Hopefully, everything will go well. But I wanted to wish the both of you the very best going forward. And, you know, I just want people to know, you know, Matthew has been such a good friend to me, always loyal, you know, when I've always needed help, he always seems to be there, you know. You're a good man, Matt, and I know you have a good woman in Laura, and I wish you the very best of success, and go from there. I love you both, okay, and congratulations. Bye-bye.
That was very sweet. Matt and Laura, would you come over this direction for me, please? And Richard, would you come up?
Okay, I'm a little flat-footed here because I thought Paul's was going to be it. But anyway, Laura, very happy to have you in the family. And every time I call the house, I'm asking for you because I don't get an answer from him. Three times, what time you landing? What time you landing? Well, I'm ironing a shirt. I'm ironing a shirt. Next time you're cutting your hair. The third time I said, where's Laura? So I wish you all the best. Stay happy. And love each other forever.
Thank you.
Okay.
Thank you. That's right. Thank you.
It's unconventional that this day should come. A daughter giving away her mom. But there's no one else the three of us would give you away to. We know Grampy would love nothing more than to be here walking you down the aisle, but he had an even more important job. He handpicked Matt and sent him to you. Here are our wishes for you.
We hope you continue to be as happy as you've been since meeting Matt. Years ago, being truly happy seemed like such a faraway dream. You were a single mom putting yourself through nursing school while working nights with two toddlers and a teenager. You still managed to be the best mom, never missing a single recital or cheering competition, always being there when we or anyone needed anything. And you're somehow even more beautiful now than ever before. When I was little, I'd roll my eyes when everyone said we look alike. Now there's no better compliment. I hope that you wake up even on the bad mornings and just smile because you finally have what you've always wanted. Maybe it didn't happen the way you planned and the road to get here was long, winding, and treacherous, but nevertheless, you got here.
And we hope it's all worth it. We hope the paths you have each been on that have brought you to this point in your lives are worth it because now you have what most people aren't so lucky to find in a lifetime. I hope that all of the sadness, loss, tears, trials, and tribulations that have brought you to this, one of the greatest moments of your life, besides having us. I hope that this happiness makes it all worth it. You both deserve to be happy now. Mom, ever since you've met Matt, ever since your first date, your eyes have been brighter, a happiness we've never seen you live and be. And we hope that never goes away. Matt, not only do you make my mom feel so incredibly loved, but you go above and beyond at being a father figure ingrained into our daily lives, and that takes a special person. And we hope you both continue to communicate and understand each other as you and as we evolve as a family.
What do you want to say? You can't squish it.
We'll do it after.
We hope you both continue to be good to each other. Matt. We hope you never stop seeing our mom as the prize you had your eye on always. We hope you can handle her crazy suggestions like orange bar stools and never deny her a plant. We hope you continue to love and appreciate her more every day like we do. Mom, we hope you never stop getting genuinely excited to pick up Matt from the train. Never get tired about hearing of his golf days and always check the toothpaste bottle. to make sure he's not brushing with itch cream. We hope you appreciate this man who is taking on the role of husband, father, and grandfather, all because of his love for you. We hope you motivate each other to be your best selves, encourage each other to go after what you want, and never forget the rare gift you each are.
And lastly, we love you both. We hope you build a life together that's better than you ever could have imagined. Cheers to our mom and stepdad.
I love you.
That's not the last one. It's a little surprise one. It's quick. To an old friend and a new friend, may your life together be filled with happiness and adventure. May your love carry you through your journey together, and may your blessings be immeasurable. Congratulations and much love, Doug and Trudy.
So I just want to thank Laura and I both want to thank everyone for coming. We know it's quite a journey with getting by COVID and all of that, but we still got a lot of people to come down here for this, and we know you wouldn't be here if we didn't mean something to each other, friends and family and all of that. As far as my new role here, it's already been going on for a couple of years. I've been trying to learn how to be a stepfather and things like that, and it's its own animal in a way, because the way I approach it is I kind of just I watch and just listen, and I don't get involved for quite a while. And Laura's, yeah, I mean, yeah, I mean, hey, Laura's very strict, and they have a chat group called the 4 P's in a Pod, so whenever there's a problem, the phones are going off nonstop for about 45 minutes. And so, Laura takes charge sort of as a president and goes on for a while, and then by the end of the 45 minutes, Kelly's the president and Laura's the vice president. So that's what I've learned so far, but it's a thrill to have them, and they're all incredibly unique, and I love them all, and I'm looking forward to the future. Going forward, and of course I want to thank Laura for finally ending up with me after a long, long wait.
So. I'm not good at this.
You don't have to.
Worth every second.
I so appreciate everybody coming here, and yes, I am so glad that he had the patience to wait for me to finally come around. Although he never talked to me, he would come up and literally, "I knew you'd be here," and off he'd go. So, in my defense, he never said a word to me. So, and then one night we got together at Chianti, but not on purpose. He was stalking me. It was him. But he ended up staying and talking the whole night, and we haven't stopped talking since.
And
so happy. I'm so grateful to God for this chance.
Right.
And for my girls to have him as well, because he's so good to them. I love you.
Thank you, Brandon.
Thank you.
You were better to me than I was to myself. For me, there's you, and there ain't nobody else. I wanna stop. Thank you, baby. I just wanna stop. And thank you, baby. Oh, yes.
How sweet it is to be loved by you. How sweet.
got it. Oh, honey, honey, you are my candy girl, and you got me wanting you. Honey, oh, sugar, sugar,
that's right. warm that dance floor up. Get it ready to go.
Something that I gotta do. I don't wanna look back in 30 years and wonder who you're married to. Wanna say it now, wanna make it clear for only you and God to hear. When you love someone, they say you set them free, but that ain't gonna work for me.
The new Mr. and Mrs. Silva. Ladies and gentlemen, in helping Laura and Matt plan this evening, I asked them to dedicate a secret song to each other and only tell me what that song is. So what I'd like to do now is start with Matt's dedication to Laura, and it goes like this.
We've been to both Carolinas, seen a big Montana sky, driven up and down the coast a few times, London, Paris, paradise. But ain't got much memory of the scenes, come to think I missed them all. And damn, babe, it's all your fault. No matter where we go, no matter what we do, if you're there, girl, I've got my eyes on you. Don't matter where we've been, no, there ain't no better view than you in my arms, with my eyes on you, with my eyes on you, with my eyes on you. Speaking of the coast, remember Fiver Beach, you and me, that sunset, cliffs by the sea, and the night rolled in, and you still talk about that moon that I can't recall, but God, I saw all I needed to. Might as well have stayed in the room. No matter where we go, no matter what we do, if you're there, girl, I've got my eyes on you. Don't matter where we've been, no, there ain't no better view than you in my arms.
you remember Times Square? And people counting down everywhere. 2000, whatever, no, I didn't care. So baby, you were there. And once again, couldn't help but stare. No matter where we go, no matter what we do, if you're there, girl, I've got my eyes on you. It don't matter where we've been, no, there ain't no better view than you in my arms with my eyes on you. Halfway around the world, over a local corner booth, yeah, you guessed it, girl, you know I got my eyes on you. We can be on any street, any party, any room, I'll be there all night with my eyes on you. Don't matter.
Eyes on You by Chase Rice. No, from Matt to Laura. What a beautiful song. That's a great tune. Now we've got a special dedication from Laura to Matt. Now, why would you say that? Scary? I wouldn't say scary. I will say this. She did give me two or three options, and I'm a little confused as to what I'm really supposed to do here. So anyway, Laura's dedication to Matt goes like this. Oh.
No.
I guess I made a mistake. I'm sorry. Hopefully this is it. Man, you know, I programmed this out just right, and I was hoping it'd be perfect. Hopefully this is it. Ah, yes, this is it.
He's a phone call to his parents. He's a Bible by the bed. He's the t-shirt that I'm wearing. He's a song stuck in my head. He's solid and he's steady like the Allegheny runs. He knows just where he's going and he's proud of where he's from. One of the good ones.
Gabby Barrett called the good ones. Ladies and gentlemen, if you'd like to come up and join them at this time, come on up and dance with them, please.
By standing on the wall,
get your back up on the wall.
Tell me,
packages by standing on the wall.
Get your back up off the
wall. Cause I heard all the people saying,
get down on it, get down on it, get down on it, get down on it.
When you're dancing,
get down on it, get down on it, get down on it, get down on it.
Shout out, 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 out. Get down.
Life is your crazy love. If I never